Hello and welcome back to javanines.com. In this module, we're going to discuss about the linked list. Linked list is an ordered collection. So it is an interesting implementation of list and has some extra functionality compared to ArrayList and Vector. So if you take a look at the hierarchy of the linked list, you can see that it is from the list and it is also implementing the queue and double-ended queue interfaces. So most of the methods from list have been discussed in ArrayList module. So we will focus on the queue and double-ended queue features of linked list. So what is the difference between normal list-based implementations like ArrayList, Vector versus the linked list? So with ArrayList or Vector, when we add an element without specifying an index, they place that element at the end of the list by default. With the linked list, because it is double-ended queue, we can add the element from the front or at the end of the list. So to enable this linked list, implement a range of methods to be able to add, remove, and get elements from front or from the end of the collections. That is the reason why if you notice the methods of the linked list, you can see AddFirst, AddLast kind of methods, getting repeated. Like, you know, you see the first and last signatures inside the method. Before getting into the details of the linked list, we should know what is a queue. Because linked list is implementing queue interface, we should know what is a queue is about. The reason for bringing the discussion of queue while discussing linked list is that linked list is an important implementation of queue and dequeue interfaces. So what is a queue? A collection where elements get added and will be placed at the end of the data structure. And when fetching, elements should be accessed from the front or kind of head of the data structure. Then this is what list does, right? So what is the difference between list and queue? With list, we can access element at a particular index. That means I can ask to give an element at the 10th index with the list. But with the queue interface, it does not provide any facility to access elements at a particular index. We only have opportunity to ask what is your first element and what is the last element. And access to the elements in between will not be provided. Okay, so that's what is queue, right? You will not call the people in between the queue and serve them. It is about, you know, serving the from the first or from the last, you know, ordering something from the last. So that's like FIFO, first in first out or last in first out kind of structure. So this image represents the FIFO queue, that is a first in first out kind of it. And then we have LIFO. If you have requirements like, you know, last in and first out, then it is like a stack. So we need to pull the elements from the end of the collection, that is you stack the elements, first element will go to the bottom and the last element will always be on the top. So for this kind of LIFO kind of data structure, we need to pull the last element in the first place. So having implemented the list, queue and dequeue interfaces, linked list can be effectively used as queue as well as a kind of stack, because we will be able to add elements from both the ends and fetch from both the sides. So let us take a look at the methods of the linked list. The list based methods are already discussed in our list session. So I will only talk about the specific methods that are special to this linked list implementation. To elaborate on the methods, AddFirst method adds an element to the beginning of the list. AddLast will add the element to the end of the list. GetFirst gets the first element. GetLast will get the last element. And RemoveFirst and RemoveLast methods will remove the first and last elements respectively. So let me go ahead and give a short demonstration about the linked list with these methods so that we can understand the functioning of the collection much better with other methods before we proceed. Okay, so I have already created an execution class for the linked list, the main method. I have created this linked list collection and I'm filling it up with some 100 car elements there. So it's just a registration number with H with some index I. So it will be like H0, H1, H2, H3. Now that we are going to try the AddFirst and Add method. So AddFirst and AddLast method. So I'm just going to insert some first. So you can see that I'm just saying for H first, linked list dot add last. H last, and we can access the elements with get first and get last, right? So I'm just going to use this get first and then linked list dot get last. So you can see that the elements are getting added, or here H first and H last. Okay, so I can also go ahead and remove the elements using linked list dot remove last, linked list dot remove first. Okay, so I'll just bring these two statements down so that I can access the first and last elements again. So here I'm adding, here I'm removing. So the first element has to be H0 and the last one should be 99. So that's what we are getting here. Okay, so then coming to the other methods. So we have methods like peak first and peak last. Peak retrieves the first element, peak first retrieves the first element again. Peak last retrieves the last element, but get first and get methods also does the same, right? Like get can be used to get an element at a particular index. So this is specific to list interface, but peak terminology is specific to the queue interface. That means, you know, peak is nothing but taking a quick look. So when I say peak, it's taking a quick look at the first or last elements. But if you see peak relevant implementations, you will not be able to get an element at a particular index. So that is because a queue does not give access to the elements at a particular index, but you should only go ahead with the first or last elements in the queue. That is the reason why that these methods are from queue and dequeue interfaces. They should support this terminology of queues. So if your implementation is queue specific, then you should use these methods. And if your implementation is for the list specific, then you got to use this get related methods. Then coming to the poll methods, they are kind of combi operations. So poll method retrieves and then removes that element in one shot. So let us take a look at the poll method. So I'm doing kind of linked list dot poll first, so that I can remove the element from the first position. Then I'm going to poll the last. Okay, so then we will see what happens with the first and last positions of it. So you can see that H0 and H99 are gone, H1 and H98 are present here. So that's the use of a poll, that it retrieves and removes the elements in one shot. So that's a kind of, you know, quick operations with the queue. That means you just when you finished working with the first element, you don't have to retrieve it out from the collection and then remove it. You just say poll first, then again poll first, so it keeps on removing the first element that is present in the collection. Then coming to the next set of methods, we have offer related methods, which are also work like add. So that means obviously when you talk about this offer first and offer last, they are again using internally, they are using add related methods there. So if you look at the linked list source code, you can clearly find them find that they are using add related methods internally. So finally, there is something called descending iterator, which helps to iterate from the last index of the collection. So linked list is implementing the DQ interface is like a kind of, you know, double-edged sword. If you think the element you want can be reached much faster from the end of the collection, we can use this, you know, detached descending iterator. Or if you feel like, you know, the element was inserted much early in the collection, then you can iterate from the first using a normal iterator. So let us take a look at the descending iterator once. So I can go ahead and write an iterator. Car kind of iterator. Car last iterator. Okay, I'm just going to and say that linked list dot descending iterator. And now a while loop to iterate through. So has next, then I'm going to print the registration number out here. So car last iterator dot next. So we should be able to see that the order of printing will be from H98, 97, 96, like that. So you can see that, right? So it is coming from 98, 97, something like that. So these two are actually, the first two are printing this get first and get last. So please ignore them, because you might be confused why H1 is there. Actually, it is because of these two statements. Okay, the actual iteration starts here. Okay, so that's about the linked list. And now that we have seen some functionality of this linked list, most of the people are not clear where we can apply this linked list. So I created a small brain teaser for you to write simple code where you can apply this linked list. I want you to create a pizza store which prepares pizzas and delivers pizzas. So the customers call to give orders for pizzas. So pizza store should maintain a queue of customers and a stack of pizzas. The first customer in queue will get the pizza on top of the stack. So when customer receives the pizza, delete the customer from the queue and a pizza from the stack. You can use two linked list collections for this, one for the customers and one for the pizzas. Or if you want to add more creativity, you can also use threads. One manages the customers, the other manages this pizzas adding and deleting to the stack. So finally, a delivery boy who delivers the pizza should be responsible to delete a customer and delete a pizza from the stack and this queue. So go ahead and make one and share your experience with me. That's all for this module. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to like, and if you have any questions, please feel free to post as a comment. I will try to answer as soon as possible. Subscribe to my channel to get more updates on the tutorials. Thank you and have a nice day.